Hi everybody, screw you again, and it is first thing in the morning over here, and I need to get my heart rate up and get my blood pumping, so what better way than to lose a game to Dominion? And this is going to be against Ilya. I have a 5-2, and let's take a look at this board real quick. Okay. I'm not saying any attacks I need to play around. I don't think that Rogue is going to be terribly impactful. Opening up with a raise is always good. It's going to help me control my deck. What's my end game look like? Looks like playing a bunch of Merchant's Guilds is going to feature prominently here, I think. And cities are going to factor in once a pile gets out. So let's grab a raise to get started. And my first five is interesting. Even though Merchant's Guilds are something I really want to get started with, I'm not thinking that it's really necessarily my first five. So it's something that's really going to boost me along here. I could see mine being okay. Yeah, an early mine is good because, you know, I'm not really gonna want to use raise to thin those coppers if I can get away with it, I don't think. And it'll improve the quality of my deck, so. Now let's go ahead and grab a Merchant's Guild, because the extra buy is going to help me get more raises. What do I do with this three? That was a weird call between Caravan Guard and Silver. And I don't think I'm getting either right now. I think I'm just getting another raise. But see, the thing is that, like, a lot of my payload is going to be Merchant's Guilds, and Silver is going to get between me and drawing them. But the silver is also going to help me buy more of them, so. Let's go ahead and grab the silver for now. It'll help me spike the price points I want to be spiking more often. And then once I have more of these fibers in my deck that I want, I can focus on getting around the silvers to draw them. And at this point, I'm kind of looking at a city. Eventually these raises are going to pile. I'm going to need a village for my deck anyway. Yeah. This last card is the Merchant's Guild, so I'll probably get two raises next turn. And that means that the raise pile is going to be pretty low pretty soon, so cities are going to be a pretty good card pretty soon. So let's grab one. Okay. This is good. I drew my city for the first time with two terminal actions. I'm pretty happy about that. Let's go ahead and turn the silver into something that I'm happy about raising. If it comes down to that. And I chose to turn the copper into silver instead of turning silver into gold because I would like to be able to raise it if necessary and get some value out of that. So at this point, I'm thinking two raises or maybe raise Caravan Guard. I kind of like two raises. Get control of my deck. Two coin tokens. Now, so I want to thin the copper, but I'm also not really wanting to keep myself from hitting five because I want to probably get a city. So Even though I want the raise in my deck, I think I am going to raise the raise just so that I don't not hit five. And I'm not really ready to raise the silver yet. So let's go ahead and do this. And it doesn't really matter. I'm buying a city either. Oh, I have coin tokens. It doesn't matter. Okay. I don't have a buy. So I'm gonna get a city here. Okay. My opponent has one city, so that split is looking in my favor so far. Ooh. Probably a Merchant's Guild for the buy. Okay. So I have five. And I'll probably spend these coin tokens, or coffers, I should say, and grab City Race. I've hit eight. That's interesting. Eight and one buy. I know the meme here is that I should buy a province because you gotta spend all your money every turn, but I'm considering it. No, that's terrible. Because, like, okay, these piles are gonna be low is my reasoning, but, like, no, I can't not just buy a city. I have dreams of doing better than a province per turn. And having a province in my deck right now is gonna slow me down, not speed me up. I should try to keep tabs on how the city split is looking. Right about now, it looks like my opponent has sort of gotten wise to that fact, so he's probably gonna buy one himself here, yeah. Okay. So if I buy another city, I'm turning on the cities for both of us. Probably fine to do it, but something I need to be aware of. Let's go ahead and thin this copper. No. Let's thin the silver and take. Silver probably. At least I can cycle through my deck a little bit that way. I don't know if I'm rationalizing there. And okay. I'll leave it to him to turn on the cities and get or am I? No. I'm just gonna grab City Race. And I'll let the cities be turned on, but I'll have one more for it. I think I won that split. If I have tracked it correctly, I do think that I have six of them. But I could be wrong about that. So. Okay, he grabs a rogue. Okay, that's fair. He could be trashing cities and maybe gaining them with that. I should watch out for rogue, actually. Is that a problem? If it is, I'll grab one. Okay. So now, right, turn that copper into a silver. Turn the silver into nothing and city, and see. Okay. So yes, I do have six cities. I was right about that. Thin this copper out. And the thing is, like, actually, Rogue by that same token might be a pretty good card for my deck. Oh, it'd be gaining silvers, which is fine, but not great. Like, the silvers, what I want to be playing are Merchant's Guilds, and the silvers will get in the way of that. But not by that much. I'm overdrawing a little bit here. And I have the raises to raise them if it really becomes a problem. So let's go ahead and grab a rogue and a merchant guild. And that way, if he does happen to play a rogue and trash one of my cities, then I can... Oh, well, he's not going to be able to do that until he gains all the silver that's in the trash anyway. So maybe I don't really need to play around that. The thing is, though, like, rogue is going to help me gain silver from the trash and then play it that turn because I'm overdrawing. So that's, you know, worth noting. All right, let's grab that. And let's raise one. It's kind of annoying. Yeah. Okay. So, turn this copper into a silver. And let's see, what are we looking at here? I should grab an outpost this turn. I could have up to $14. I'm getting two coffers every time I buy, so I should grab an outpost. Possibly another rogue. And a caravan guard. Caravan guard gives me some payload without compromising my deck control, so yeah. So, outpost, rogue, and caravan guard. It's a tough call between rogue and merchant guild here, but whatever. So, let's grab that. Obviously, once somebody buys this raise, if somebody does buy it, the cities get turned on for everybody, so that's a thing. I should full screen. Oh, hey, I get to react with Caravan Guard. Caravan Guard does get to react to Rogue, so that's cool, I guess. It's not really my intention when I bought it, but, you know, it's neat. He gains a silver, which he can draw and play this turn. Can he? Maybe. I have the same kind of overdraw right now that I do. I probably should have grabbed an outpost earlier. That would have been pretty good, because now he's getting to take an extra turn. Okay, so he goes ahead and gets the initiative on greening. And he gets a province, and he's probably going to try to three-pile this turn. And he might do it. Oh man, did I just get outplayed? Because, like, to be fair, he could have maybe seriously three-piled me this turn. And now I'm probably going to get to three-pile him this turn. But that's a thing that I should have been more aware of, and I wasn't. I mean, now I'm probably just going to win, but, like, I feel like that was shame on me for not really seeing that. Okay, so let's play the outpost and the merchies. And what's in the trash? Nothing I really want to gain. Except for that silver that I just trashed of his, and let's grab it. Play the mine to turn that into a gold. So endgame play, I definitely made a mistake here. Let's take the duchy. Let's actually take an estate and a bunch of candlestick makers. It'll help me three pile on my outpost turn. Now let's take the province. And
some coppers. Make sure I can three pile. Yeah. I need some coppers to be able to. Oh no! The coppers looks like they were a bad idea. No, they weren't. I can just pile provinces. Or, you know. Okay, so my end game has been sloppy as all get out, let's be honest. I was a buy short of piling provinces and I spent all my coin tokens for no reason. I think I'm gonna win either way because I was so ahead for other reasons. But if I do lose it, it's because of some things that you've witnessed here that I'm not super proud of. Okay. And, like, I have such a point lead, and there's only one province left that, like, he's gonna have a really hard time. But, like, I'm almost rooting for him at this point, because he's the underdog, and I played the endgame so badly that I opened it up for him, so, like, if he does, okay, he resigns, but, like, man, that's embarrassing. Okay, well, good. Good game, Ilya, and I will see you guys next time.